expended will then donate it to a woman's shelter in
Come on.
And then the other part will go to the B-Day organization, which has a campaign this year in Haiti to help the women and girls in Haiti. It's a really important connection. All the money that we bring in, we did vagina monologues, we got $1,500 for our donation. The blacked out rage, the uncontrollable sobbing that for once this night it was induced by his decision to drown himself into oblivion. To drown the fact that he had been lost for a very long time. And the realization that I could not save him from himself. I am so very grateful every day that I left before he went so low as to go. But he yelled and he blamed and he destroyed. And my God, it.
Take care, dude.
Ladies came by and they said, "Hey, that's a great song. And
threw down like a dollar and a half in change.
That's right. All right.
And
that's
those are all the details she gave me. I would assume that means that ladies get in for free. So it was a good time, I guess. I mean, it's fun. It's fun. If you want to dance, like, you know, I don't mean to.
Why are you selling it?
Together, LGBT and poetry and blackness and everything. I'm just gonna read my poem that I read at my illness. Not to be mistaken by the two or consolidated into one, my illness has not caused me to assume an imaginative identity. I guess that's why my doctor will never consider my conversation about getting on testosterone real or coherent. Because in my mind, I can be all. Schizophrenia didn't cause me to like girls or want to transition to a man when I was 14, nor did it cause me to imagine my virginity to be taken from me. Because you can't be genderqueer and raped, and you can't be schizophrenic and raped, and you can't be a raped, genderqueer, schizophrenic. They don't belong together. A man taking a transitioning man's virginity is not the same as a heterosexual girl take being raped by a heterosexual guy, because that's the only time police will assume your fake identity and question you, like, how can a man rape another man outside of steel bars and community showers? No, you are mistaken. The only identity not true to me is me being labeled as a slut or promiscuous or fat because some guy decided that he was angry I was perpetrating. And I'm trying to figure out if he was mad because he was attracted to a man. I'm tired of breaking code, because if you're Christian, you're never supposed to be lonely, because God is always with you. Because you can't be lonely and Christian, or raped and schizophrenic, or schizophrenic and genderqueer. They don't belong together. I will never be able to claim my identity as a lonely, raped, genderqueer, schizophrenic Christian. Too many contradictions. They don't belong together. They never belong together. But if you dissect them all, I will never be this whole person. Through all the brokenness, I am still whole. I'm still above ground. I haven't fell apart yet. Or maybe that's what they expected, that I'd be hospitalized again for contradictions that cannot be fixed. They say 7 is the number of completion in Christianity. Then why, after my 7th hospital visit, I wasn't completely over this illness? Good Friday, last Good Friday, ended my 8th hospital stay. I believe it's because they want me broken. The rapists wanted me broken. My church wanted me broken so I could repent of my identity. Then maybe I would be normal, because it's not normal to be a lonely, raped, genderqueer, schizophrenic Christian, because I can't be Christian in any of those things. I am wholly broken. Thank you.
Whoa.
For Ben Shapiro.
How I feel about us.
I'm